There is no answer to Avascular necrosis, Dr. Ramesh, and there is no gold standard as far as the management is concerned. I have seen cases of vascular fibrografting. Rakesh knows Karad at Jaipur, went from my institution for treatment and collapse occurs. So there is no gold standard. Work is going on. You may put in umbrella with a graft, or you may put in some implant with a surface kind of arthroplasty. Collapse will still occur. Yes, no research is done as far as osteotomy is concerned, because industry is dominating for THR. But I tell you, if you talk of simple in terms of osteotomy, you are putting mesenchymal cells, you are putting growth factors, you are putting BMPs, everything. What is this osteotomy? Normally you have bone marrow spurate put at the site of non-union, 3-4 sittings, 6-7 sittings to invite union. But here you are extending an invitation for the proliferation of mesenchymal cells, the natural stem cells, the natural osteoblasts, and a race may go on between the creeping substitution, again neovascularization. Are you able, or the process is able, to remove that dead bone, the aseptic bone, and cause the viability of the head of the femur? I think this is the future, and the scientists, the researchers must look into it. Something will also come from Dr. my dear friend from Nagpur. He will talk to you regarding its management. Classification a lot has been talked by Dr. Ramesh, particularly RCC classification, the recent one, the latest one. Here we can do quantification in this Pennsylvania classification, where the environment is 15% or 15-30% or more than 30%. That is mild, moderate, or severe involvement of the head of the femur. And these are some of the various procedures, the operative options for the management of this entity, which has been very highly spoken by my friend Dr. Ramesh. Two types of osteotomy, three types of osteotomies we are doing on: valgus, varus, and trans-trochanteric rotational osteotomies of Sugiyoka, which he has shown some pictures. It has a mechanical role and a biological role, which has to be investigated seriously with a concern, which all we want to find the management of avascular necrosis. The cause may be any. And as usual in literature, you find that this brings about reduction in the intraosseous pressures and improvement in microcirculation, which again has to be looked in. And this enhances the repair activity and healing process by stimulating neovascularization and new bone formation. That is what osteotomy is supposed to do. And I will talk to you on my certain observations, because the real research is still not being done as far as this subject is concerned. Mechanically, one can take away the well-circumscribed area of a necrosis from away from the weight-bearing dome, and that may facilitate the neovascularization and cause, bring about the viability of the avascular or aseptic zone of the head of the femur. You see here, if you see the relative classification, the head and neck is involved. And we have done a varus osteotomy. You see here, this is after 231 weeks. And this is after 20 years, the head is completely viable. Just a varus osteotomy, contain the necrotic area, bring it away from the weight-bearing dome, which was there because of the valgus position. It works in three situations, both in pre-collapse, collapse, and in arthritic situations. You find here, this is type 3 crescent as per Fickett and Arlett classification, or for other classifications here. And if you do an osteotomy, this takes away the head of the femur away from the weight-bearing dome, and the head becomes viable. You find here still the cystic changes are there, but there is no collapse. So in pre-collapse situation, osteotomy does very well, you have to decide you want to do a valgus osteotomy or a varus osteotomy. This is 237 weeks, and you find here this is after 11 years, the head is viable. There is no deterioration at all. And I have done the MRI on this patient that showed the enhancement changes. Again, you see the relative classification, valgus osteotomy done. You find here the joint space is slightly reduced. There is sclerosis, but the head is viable. And this is after 24 weeks. Excellent motion, excellent movements. This is when she was studying for a master's degree, and now she is married. This is the daughter, and at her age, I operated the mother child, and you find that there is good follow-up. The head is viable. Pre-collapse situation works very well, even if there is a uniform collapse. Now see my follow-up. This is not a research. I'm just showing you my results. There is uniform collapse of the head of the femur. See, this is 60 years male. I did it in 1992. This failed osteosynthesis, and you find this increased density and the loss of bone. This is 28 weeks. It is united. The capsule is not divided. Just valgus position. You see here, there is a uniform collapse, reduced in size, united below along the calcar, not here. And this is just preoperative, 14 years, 6 months back. And patient has excellent function. He can squat, he can sit cross leg. So uniform collapse, even if it occurs after an osteotomy, this works very well. We have to look into it, why it is so. Again here, non-union here, after 10 years, there is, you find grade 3-4 changes. Mild collapse here, increased density, implant is out, but this patient is still pain-free. So osteotomy works even if there is a collapse, but a uniform reduction in the size of the head of the femur. Same is here, you find at 98 weeks, it is viable. At 305 weeks, you find there is a collapse in the weight-bearing dome. This is 13 years, you see there is a collapse. Both in AP view as well as in frog leg view, but the patient has excellent range of motion. He can squat on toes and sit cross-legged position even after 15 months of the collapse in this patient. So short, why it is working, what is the reason, I don't know that. See here, there is protrusii, avascular necrosis arthritis. Patient is still pain-free after 16 years, and this is after 21 years. The range of motion is decreased, abduction is decreased, flexion is decreased, but the patient is pain-free. So avian with arthritis, if osteotomy is there, it still works. It's most valuable in treating patients with stage 1 and stage 2. This is what has been said, and if we cite, this is what literature says. In pre-collapse stage, the core decompression. Now this is one of the cases of core decompression. He is a doctor. You find here where the dill was put in. This again where the dill was put in. It works. It is stage 2. But stage 3, crescent, you see. If you put a fibro graft, this fails to maintain the structure. See here, there is a collapse. This is the fibula. This is after 300 weeks. This boy studies in St. Stephen's School, college. And here if you do now a valgus osteotomy, it will work because there is impingement here. Abduction is limited in this patient. There is impingement, but there is full range of motion as far as flexion is concerned. So this is after 11 years, and I feel like doing a valgus osteotomy, which will positively work. You see here, the fibular grafting is done. There is a crescent sign, but there is a collapse also. So there is impingement. This patient is referred to me from Kanpur, but I don't think now valgus osteotomy has a role because there is already a collapse. And a big area, more than one-third of the head of the femur is involved. This much area is the collapse. So answer is THRS at this situation. However, here you find that there is a crescent sign. you can confirm the avian changes on CT because it's a treated case. Now here, I have put a fibrograft to give a spore and done the valgus astrotomy with it so that the aseptic zone is away from the weight-bearing dome, and this has worked very well. This is after, you see, this is CT after this treatment. Here I put in the fibula. This is after 10 years, still working. Osteotomy with fibrograft in the area of crescent to prevent the collapse and take it away from the weight-bearing dome. This can be repeated if OA changes occur, the joint space is reduced, thinking that other healthy cartilage area will come in congruency to give him a good function. And here, this was the initial osteotomy, and this is the second osteotomy, though there is valgus, and patient had some limp because of the disturbance of the body lever arm and muscle lever arm, but the patient was pain-free till his death. And I say here that by doing osteotomy, you invite proliferation of your mesenchymal cells, the stem cells, the osteoblastic activity, and maybe this is the future when more and more research is there. This is what is published in Campbell's My Technique by Maguachar, and I thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Magu. Any questions, please? Yes, sir.
That will depend upon the area of the involved. If you want that the healthy area is located superiorly and posteriorly, you will do a flexion osteotomy, and this will come in the weight-bearing dome. So you have to plan it on the CT or on cephaloid or caudal X-rays. And normally, if you excise the wedge of 20 to 30 degrees, this will bring the head of the femur or the aseptic zone, which is generally there is, you find avascular changes. This will bring it out of the very, very dome of the acetabulum. And you'll feel that the abduction of this patient is increased because of the abduction osteotomy. And this gives a healing effect positively.
To bring the healthy head into the weight-bearing area, if you need to extremely valgize or varize, do these patients have a limp?
Yeah, you should not do extreme valgus.
Yeah.
Because the body lever arm will be disturbed.
So there is a limit.
The level of the top of the trochanter must be at the level of the center of the head of the femur. So you just excise a wedge of about 20 degrees.
It's maximum 20 degrees.
Yeah, 20 degrees.
And suppose by chance the avian progresses, does it make your arthroplasty options
compromised? Yes, you can still, that is what I wanted to say. You can still do a THR. You should not do too much of medialization or lateralization. But remodeling helps you. And I have seen that even after 14, 15 years, a good marrow is formed, a new marrow is formed, and THR is not difficult. A lot of literature is there.
Thank you, sir.
Like he said, that in area, in cases where the area is much more than limited to a area which can be sort of taken away from the weight-bearing area by an osteotomy, because you can go only up to a certain extent in valgalization. So is it possible that more than mechanical, is the biological components that are acting in?
Absolutely. This is what Marty has also written.
Yeah.
See, even if the whole of the head is involved, but there is no collapse. Osteotomy works very well.
Possibly some decompression element is also happening with osteotomy.
Yeah, yes, this causes decompression because you are making a track and then taking it out. Pressure is released, the venous pressure is decreased at the osteotomy site, and neovascularization starts. This is an area of research which we should take up now.
I think it's possibly more of biological factors than mechanical factors which are